My sister went there, and she had a lot of experience, so I would want to go to the U.S.
Yes, it may be a difference of my family. If they say okay, I will go.
It's fantastic to study there, but I prefer to study here at Bahrain. It will be a good opportunity.
I don't want.
Of course, I'd love to. Yeah.
Of course, yes.
I think, yeah, if I get a scholarship, I won't refuse.
I want to study in America because the level of education is higher than Bahrain.
Okay, especially no. Because there are different culture, okay? Different ways to teaching, okay? I want to study here in Bahrain only.
No, I don't really prefer that because I prefer to stay here with my family. I don't like to study abroad.
One of the great things about the US is how much they value diversity and different cultures. It's really funny because my whole life I'd gone to a British school and I never considered going to the US. And then I think it was my senior year of high school. I was in London, I was at boarding school and it was raining and I thought, I don't think I want to stay here.
And when I got to my room in the dorms, I just wanted to sleep after this long flight. And when I woke up in the morning, I saw the views from my window. The mountains are surrounding the university. It was really beautiful.
Going up into the mountains with friends, spending the night there, skiing, hiking, doing mountain courses where, you know, you're hanging by ropes from, you know, different edges of the mountain and crossing over and relying on teamwork and stuff like that. So I think that's a very big and important part of the States that every student who wishes to go there has to experience in order to get, you know, a full US experience.
First, studying wise, I studied 4 years psychology, but what I learned during these 2 years were like 1,000 times more than what I learned in these 4 years. So that's one thing. Like education wise, I really gained a lot in my degree.
I wanted to experience myself, what I'm capable of, because this kind of protectivity was not allowing me to experience life.
It gives you the space to be who you are and just be proud of who you are and literally become the true person you are, because in America you can make a career out of anything.
I felt very safe in New York. You know, it's the city that never sleeps, so there was always people up. There was always people around.
I could even tell you that it's safer than Bahrain. And the whole worries about scarf and all of that, nothing was there. People were just too respectful.
It's the perfect place to play, perform, record, and meet people that would inspire you.
America on the television is different than America in reality. Of course, they are the same houses, the same streets, the same weather, but the people are not like everyone is violent and everyone is sick. And, you know, it's not like that. People live in, like, everyone minds his or her own business in life. They don't interfere in your life in general. So don't be scared.
So I kept saying, no, I'm not hungry, maybe later. And by 5 o'clock that afternoon, they were like, seriously, you have to sit down and have something to eat. So I said, well, actually, you know, I'm fasting. It's Ramadan. And they all just gave me a hug. And they were like, why didn't you say so?
I think to get the full cultural experience of being in America, of being a student in an American university there, that I should stay and live with American people. And basically, I lived with two American friends who started out as roommates, but eventually turned out to be really, really good friends.
In the beginning, you know, you get a lot of thoughts of, oh, I just want to go back home, or I just want to move somewhere where I'm closer to friends, change universities. But I think if you stick it out for the first 4 to 5 months, you'll start to realize that, you know, friends, you know, you can make friends anywhere.
The international office is a very busy place. It's not like just created and just thrown over there. When we went there, there were students who helped us. There were Muslim students who helped us find a place, find halal food, find a car, you know, everything.
When we had all these orientation and, oh, be aware of the culture shock, food, it's like Bahrain. All the restaurants that are in Bahrain, they're there as well. So that was no problem at all.
They were Arabic, they were Muslims, but they were not mingling with others. They were not having any relationships, any communication with the local people. So the local people started to be not comfortable with them. And they thought that this is maybe a prejudice. But it was not anything like that, because they did not try to mingle with people. And people thought that maybe they were weird, maybe they were not nice or something like that. Because American people are really nice. They're open and they will talk to you whenever they see you. They always initiate the conversations with you.
The classroom environment in the United States, it's an open one. It's a very liberal classroom environment where people get to share their opinions very freely.
You're always engaged in the classroom. It's not a matter of, you know, here's a book or here's, you know, a syllabus and you got to know all of these things by the final date. It's always, you know, you got to learn as you go. You take one chapter at a time, you do homework, you do quizzes, you do team assignments, and you're always engaged with other people in the classroom.
So it was really active, and you get to know a lot of things, you get to understand a lot of things from your colleagues, and the professor is just monitoring us.
The equipment in the classrooms were quite advanced, like we... I might sound silly, but we got to watch videos and everything was pretty much digital in our classrooms. So it helps get the classes running more efficiently. That was nice. And the selection of the professors, I think that's what made the difference.
And from the first class, I made friends with people, and you know it was such a nice thing actually, you know. It was very welcoming, you know. I was not scared already. I'm very optimistic, but still I have this, you know, the misgiving of, you know, like I might be inferior because, you know, I was here an A student. I graduated with 3.9, and in the States, you know, they are already native speakers. So there was the kind of like 20%, 30% of like worrying, but then everything was fine.
In my class, we only had two international students, and my professors always took the time to, during the class, they would maybe explain further because of the language issues. And I remember once, one of the things that I loved about one of my professors, it was Eid, and we had an exam on Eid. And I was a bit depressed because it's Eid, it's my first Eid away from family and everything. So, and nobody even knew that it's Eid. So I just went to class, but my professor in the middle of class was like, oh, let's all congratulate Sena because it's Eid and everything, and just to make me feel a bit more at ease.
Every professor has office hours, so you can always go, and you know, which I always took advantage of that. So I didn't really feel behind, no. And I mean, if I ever did, or I felt like I didn't get something, or I didn't understand why I wasn't getting a certain grade, the door was always open to go to a professor and sit down with them during their office hours.
Definitely sports is definitely something I enjoy doing. I was part of the intramural soccer team, whereby we participated every quarter in the university in an intramural championship, and we won that a couple of times as well.
Yeah, we'd have study groups, we'd stay up in the library and study together.
We actually did a lot of community service events. We did a lot of things to, like scholarship events to better our education. A lot of social events as well with other sororities, fraternities and groups on campus. So it actually, and a lot of leadership development. So it was actually a very good experience in terms of leadership development and also being a well-rounded student.
We used to arrange a lot of dinners in our park, in BG's park. so that we can all meet and discuss whatever we want. It's basically to know more about each other's culture.
I fall in love with the American football. Yeah, but my friend's roommate introduced us to the ball to the game and said that you should come. It's really nice. They were all excited, but at the beginning I didn't know anything about the game. I just hear the word touchdown and everybody was really excited, but I didn't understand exactly what was going on.
You can't be studying 100% of the time. You need to actually experience different aspects of life, such as, you know, going out with friends, you know, going and experiencing new things, you know, skiing, snowboarding, skydiving, things that you never thought you would do. And just kind of pushing your limits to understand, you know, to understand yourself more. And, you know, if you're able to jump out of a plane that's, you know, 10,000 feet above the ground, then you know you could potentially finish an assignment that you thought you couldn't.
The most interesting part was busking in the streets. I have to mention that. It was so much fun. And I thought it was like against the law or something, but we saw police officers coming by, and they had no problem. We're not harming anyone. We're just playing music in the streets. It really made me see things in a different way. It helped also understand the American people in a better way and to appreciate their culture and to give them an opportunity to appreciate my culture as well.
I feel like now it's changed my view to the world. Like if I see somebody, I wouldn't immediately judge or have perceptions about them. I would take time or not even care. Like I learned how to overlook things.
It was pretty tough to work 20 hours a week and be a student and do all these extracurricular activities. But it's a phenomenal time management kind of, you know, crash course because you really have to manage your time so well.
Because I had to be like many things at the same time and I was there. So now I don't feel like there's anything difficult for me. If you understand what I mean, like I can't do anything. I learned from Americans how to do it on your own way. And at the same time, how to give others. I feel like in our culture, we really miss this thing, how to give others. Like if you can help someone, okay, help this person and let him live his or her life.
I actually knew what is the meaning of being open-minded when you get introduced to different people from different countries, not only the people from the US, different religions, different beliefs. I knew what it means to be Bahraini. I knew what it means to be Arabic. Yeah, I got to appreciate a lot of things that I don't even speak of or think of when I'm here in Bahrain.
I would advise every prospect or every student considering going to the United States to grasp that opportunity and to definitely make the most out of it, to engage in conversations, in debates, in cultural communications, in social activities and sports activities and traveling, and to focus on their academic career as well.
I'm advising you from heart. Don't go there with your hearts in Bahrain. You will come back to Bahrain. It's just a limited time. Be there fully.
Improving their English language before they go is not only essential, it's the main thing.
Also, I find that a lot of Bahrainis who go to college tend to stick together and tend to stick to other Khalijis or to other Arabs, which is great, but I would also recommend that you try and integrate yourself with the American culture.
If you go to the States, you are going to be more knowledgeable. You will go to a lot of conferences and you will come back much more qualified and, you know, you are very rich in culture and your field.
I mean, my advice is, you know, if you do get the opportunity to go to the States to study, give it your all, both academically and socially. Make sure that you experience as much as you can while you're there. And make sure to, you know, bring back whatever is good about that society and that community and apply it back here in Bahrain.
Show the people the bright side of your culture, the bright side of your religion, the bright side of your country. And remember, you are the symbol of that.
Mm-hmm.